Hello guys, it's Brandon. I'm back.
I almost forgot to get rid of my laundry out of the shot.
Who is going to see Rogue One? We're going to see it Sunday, so just a couple of days after the release. And I'm hoping there's no spoilers. I don't want any spoilers. I'm going to try to stay off the internet, too. One of my coworkers who watches this show, Sean, said that I look like a gangster. I only had a few people submit questions. Actually, literally two people. But the good thing is they had a couple of questions each. Where is the sun? Sun, if you have questions that you want in next week's or whenever we do the next Q&A, then leave those in the comments below. There goes the sun again. Anyway, okay, first question. Rock123 asks, his first question is, who is your favorite guitarist? And that is very hard to choose because there are so many guitarists that I follow and I love. I think maybe my most favorite guitarist is Per Nilsson of Scar Symmetry, because the way he plays is just, you know, just really fluid, and his notes are just really legato. And I would love to say that he is my one that inspires me the most, because that's Rock's next question, who inspires you the most? But probably if I were to be honest with myself and my own playing, I think that Aaron Marshall of Intervals is the one who inspires me the most, because I have taken his playing and adapted it into, you know, my playing style the most. And then Rock's last question is, how many guitars do you have? So the the first guitar, I have an acoustic guitar. It's exactly like my brother's. FA-135CE Fender acoustic. And I just like the way it sounds. Thin sound, I don't know how to describe it. Oh, I'm sorry, that was a bad tune there. That's one guitar. And then I've got the bass guitar. Ibanez SR-755, yeah. There's an electrical problem. You see this switch here? This switch is supposed to switch between active and passive. This was a used bass when I bought it. There was a saddle on this bridge, or whatever you wanna call it, was warping, and I was trying to bang it back down, and of course that didn't work. That just broke it. I must have jarred something loose, because now that switch doesn't work like it should. I should stop trying to work on my own guitars, especially when it involves a hammer. This is my most favorite guitar ever. It's my Jackson SLS MG. And if you watch my guitar documentary, which I've referenced many times over, I tell the whole story about why it's so special to me, as much as I love my H-string. Oh, and also I did a review on this too, if you want to check that out. Oh, that's three so far. I hope you've been counting. This is my fourth and last guitar that I currently own. My Ibanez RG8, my only eight string that I've ever owned. Right now I've got a low 84. And I will say this guitar is not made for really heavy strings. I've had to, like, you know, grind the hole in here and the body of the guitar down enough to get even an 80 through there, I think, but especially the 84. But in order to get it through here, you have to unravel the string down to the wire part. So anyway, yeah, those are my four guitars. If you want to hear about all the guitars I've ever owned, of course, my documentary tells the whole story. So the last person that asked a few questions was Brendan Talmadge. I hope I'm saying your name correctly. He says, sorry for the lengthy comment. That's quite all right. I have lengthy answers, as you know. Two questions for Q&A. First of all, big fan. Thank you. I came here from the Canon Rock series about 2 years ago now, and I'm continuing to really enjoy your content. Thank you. What do you think of the band Muse, and specifically their guitarist, Matt Bellamy? I don't know, I'm not really familiar at all with that band or the guy. I think I've heard the name. I've definitely heard of the band, but I don't listen to him, so I don't know, sorry. And two, okay, so here's a question that I could answer. What advice do you have for a young guitarist that is told they play extremely well but doesn't know a thing about music theory or how to write music? I'm kind of in the same boat as you, man. I don't really know a whole lot of theory. I wouldn't really worry too much about not knowing music theory right now. I mean, obviously, you've got something going for you, because you say that people's, you know, say that you play extremely well. That's awesome. You probably play a lot of covers, which is cool, man. I mean, that's how I started. I would say just keep at it. Just study what you're playing. Study Their verses and you know, like we were talking about last week, you know, study song structures. Not everybody writes music. Not everybody knows music theory, but there's a lot of people that play guitar. So I wouldn't worry too much about it, man. Just give yourself time and let yourself evolve as a musician naturally. I would just say that you can do anything that you put your mind to. So don't be discouraged. Just keep at it. And best wishes in your guitar journey. Okay, guys. Well, I guess we'll go ahead and conclude today's video. Again, if you have any questions for next week, please, yeah, post those in the comments below. If we don't have enough questions, we can always do the Q&A the later week or whatever. If there's anything that you want to talk about on these Wednesdays, let me know. I'm actually working on a Christmas single. It is We Three Kings Metal. It's kind of a August Burns Red / As I Lay Dying style, sort of like that. If you want to support me on Patreon, check the link in the description, patreon.com/BrandonBurch. We are halfway to the goal of funding my Photoshop subscription. So if we can get to that goal by the end of the year, that'd be pretty cool. Because then that way I can, you know, keep renewing my subscription and, you know, make cool thumbnails. So, yep, I guess that's all for today. We'll be done now. I'm gonna go ahead and stop this.